at the Undisputed Boxing Gym in San Carlos, California, with none other than UFC fighter, wrestler, and just kind of all-around badass, Mark Munoz. How are you?
I'm great.
Thank you for coming on the show today.
Thank you for having me.
I'm super excited to be interviewing you right now.
Oh, man, I'm super excited to be here.
Tell us a little bit about your nickname here.
I really didn't want a nickname. I kind of wanted to just be Mark Munoz, you know?
Yeah.
But my manager came up with the Philippine Wrecking Machine.
Right.
I was like, man, that has a good ring to it, man. Kind of got some flack for it because the Philippine is kind of like a... like an object, like the Philippine brand mangoes.
Yeah.
You know?
Right, that's what
you
I was
know?
Thinking. I'm like, wouldn't it be Filipino?
It's Filipino, so then it got changed to Filipino Wrecking Machine.
Got
so
it.
That's why I go by now.
So you didn't give yourself that nickname?
I didn't.
Okay, good, because that's super, like, uncool.
Yeah,
I wouldn't be.
I know.
As far as wrestling goes, how did you get into it?
So I started wrestling when I was 13.
Uh-huh.
When I was growing up, I played all the major sports. Some of my friends, they were into wrestling.
So you fell into it. It was sort of like a happy accident.
It was an accident. So I got into it and ended up liking it, and you know, and the rest is history from there. So ended up being the school's first state champion in any sport.
Really?
And the first national champion in any sport. And then I got a full ride to Oklahoma State. So it actually worked out.
Nice. Of course it did. I mean, come on, look at you now. How did that evolve into MMA?
Went to Oklahoma State, wrestled there for 4 years, coached there, and then accepted a job at UC Davis.
Okay.
And then at UC Davis, I met Uriah Faber. I attribute everything to him with me getting into the sport.
That's great.
When I accepted a job at UC Davis, he coached along with me, and he was like, dude, you need to do mixed martial arts. He brought over Randy Couture. He brought over Brandon Vera.
Oh, wow.
And that's where I met Brandon Vera. It was in Sacramento.
I see. So you guys have a history together.
We do.
Nice,
we do.
Nice.
And then he brought over who's who, like Quinn Rampage Jackson, Frank Trigg, James Irvin. And there was a host of other people that were just a who's who in mixed martial arts that just came over, and I got into it. My first sparring session was against Randy Couture.
Oh, wow.
And I was just like, I was hooked after that.
What you guys are doing with UFC, it's really become a mainstream sport, whereas before it was looked upon as sort of like a blood sport and kind of like cockfighting, I guess, if you will.
Yeah.
How do you feel being a part of that, seeing that now become so mainstream?
I think it's very cool just to see the rise of MMA. It's awesome from the roots when you said eye gouging and the bare fists.
And the makeup,
Yeah, you know, that stuff, you know, it's just from the professional wrestling to the real stuff,
right?
To where it is now, you know, just to see the evolution and how there's, you know, regulations as far as rules and stuff, and it's actually a sport now.
It's like a pure sport.
It's a pure sport now, you know, and just to see the rise and the popularity of it, you can't script it at all.
Okay, Mark, so what I'm dying to know is, what is more gratifying for you, either getting a guy to tap out or knocking him out?
Granted that I don't have any submissions on my record, I've knocked a lot of guys out, so that's what I look for.
Would you want somebody to tap out?
You know, I do, man, because a lot of people don't know about my ground game.
Yeah.
You know, and I have a very good ground game, and I've submitted, you know, black belts.
Yeah.
You know, but, you know, the time will come. You know,
so. It's gratifying either way, though.
Yeah, that's right.
To win,
just getting a W, you know.
You're such a soft-spoken, like, friendly, really. I mean, you're such a nice guy.
Yeah.
When I see you in the octagon and when I'm talking to you, it's so different.
Yeah.
How do you get your mindset in there? What's going through your head to prep for a fight and to become that guy in the octagon?
You play many roles in your life, you know. Take, for example, a teacher. You teach in the classroom, you act a different way.
Right.
But when you're home with your friends, you act a different way. So when I step into the octagon, I'm just, you know, I'm there to do what I prepared for 3 months.
Right.
You know, and then afterwards, I'm back to the way I am.
Being Mark.
Know? Yeah, being Mark.
Can you imagine if you were the Wrecking Machine all the time?
Yeah, man.
That would be awful.
I wouldn't have any friends.
I know.
You know, you know, for me, it's about improving every time I step into the octagon, you know, and improving not only as a fighter, but, you know, also too, I also want to improve on in my other roles that I play in my life, you know. So I'm a father, I'm a son, I'm a coach. I just don't want to improve on one aspect in my life.
Right, you want to be balanced,
basically. Yeah.
speaking of other roles, you own a gym. Mm-hmm. What's it called?
It's called Rain Training Center.
How did that come about, and what do you plan to do with that?
I moved down to Southern California just so that I could, you know, help my family a little bit more. It took us probably about a year because we argued back and forth. I'm like, what are you talking about, man? We got a great situation.
Yeah.
She was like, for you, not for me.
So you guys came to an agreement.
Yeah, we came to agreement.
Yeah.
And I said, you know what? I think it's time to move. And so we stepped out on faith and we moved down south. And then that's where I met a bunch of my training partners now.
Mm-hmm.
And now I have the best training camp in the world.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, congratulations on
that. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Hard work on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Hard work!
What can we expect from you in the upcoming year?
Be expecting a lot, because for me, you're going to see a great stand-up game, you know,
yeah.
Because that's what I've lacked. And in 2011, I'm definitely going to improve as a stand-up fighter. And I've made leaps and bounds from my debut.
Yeah.
And now I'm very comfortable on my feet, and I see punches coming at me now, and I see kicks. And so it's a game changer.
You know,
when you start getting comfortable on your feet, it's a game changer. So, you know, I mean, it's going to be great.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right, now, maybe the most important question of the day, really, is can we get Ariane Celeste's phone number? So we can, no?
I'll let you.
My producer wants it. So, you know.
I could probably introduce them.
Okay. Yeah. You heard it rolling. We have one more piece of business to take care of. Me and you, we're gonna throw down on this mat. Are you ready?
If you haven't wrestled before, you're in a world of hurt. So,
oh, that was not very intimidating.
You're in a world of hurt.
She's whatever.
In a world of hurt. It's like this. See this?
All right, Mark, now that I've made you tap out, my work here is done. Before I totally finish you off, do you want to tell everyone where we can find you?
Oh, you can find me at MarkMunoz.net. MarkMunoz.net, baby.
Done. All right, Mark, well, thank you for coming on the show today.
Thank you for having me.
It was a pleasure interviewing you and now finishing you off. All right, guys, I'll catch you later. See you in the studio. Ready? You're going down. Tap out, buddy. Still waiting on that phone number, Mark. Ariane.
Yeah, call me first. Yeah, don't call her.
Call me.